video, we're going to be having a look at storage. When someone buys a computer, then there's two things that they might be told about. One of them is memory and one of them is storage, and you shouldn't confuse the two. Memory is the internal memory, such as RAM, that's built onto the motherboard. But storage is things like the hard drive, where you would be saving your own personal files and programs. We'll be having a look at different types of storage in a bit later on. However, let's just concentrate on how the CPU actually gets information from storage. What it will do is it will load small chunks of the data it needs to use into RAM, which is much closer to the CPU, and it can use those to keep going while information is being loaded. It saves a lot of time and makes the whole thing a lot quicker that way. However, if the information isn't being loaded quick enough, then it might allocate a small area of the secondary storage, such as the hard drive, as a RAM, and that's known as virtual memory. That means it can start getting information from that small section of the hard drive, but if it does that too much, that's known as disk thrashing, and that slows the whole thing down and can eventually crash it. So really, if you have too many programs open at the same time, it'll slow your computer down because RAM would get filled up and then virtual memory would also get filled up. So ideally, you just need to have the programs open that you need or increase the RAM capacity. Now we're having a look at different types of storage media, and one of them is magnetic storage. Now originally, computers stored their data on large magnetic reels that could be read through spooling through a system. Nowadays, it's more likely to be held on one of these smaller, compact drives. These plates, there are several of them stacked on top of each other, and they spin round, and this magnetic head would move across them, allowing it to read the data. Now, it does allow for quite fast retrieval and saving of data. However, it's not great for portability. If it's dropped, it can corrupt the data, and if it comes into contact with strong magnetic fields or extreme heat, that can also corrupt the data. However, it does have quite large capacities. They're normally reserved for hard drives inside computers, which don't need to be moved around a lot. The second one we're going to have a look at is optical storage, such as a CD-ROM. Now this does look like it's got a lovely shiny surface, however if you zoomed in, you'd see that it's quite pitted. A laser is used to burn marks onto the surface, and then another laser is used to actually read those marks. Let's, as you can see, it's quite thin. That means it's quite good for sending along with a magazine or through the post. Once it's written, it doesn't get overwritten, so it's quite robust, but they are quite small capacity. So it's not something that people tend to use for large backups of data. The final one we're going to have a look at is solid state drive, and that can have many different formats. It might be an external hard drive, a flash drive, or even a card which is used inside a camera. As the name suggests, there's no moving parts in solid state, and if we took one of these flash drives apart, you can see that it looks like it's got chips similar to the RAM chips we were looking at in another video. This means that they're quite robust, as there's no moving parts, so if you drop them, they generally don't break. They also don't get corrupted by magnetic fields being too close by, and they do allow for a very large capacity and they're very fast. However, they do tend to be quite expensive, but the price of them is coming down, so a lot of people are starting to use them as their main backup or even in their internal hard drive on their computer.